Hey, how you doing?
Yeah.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to North Greenville University, where Christ makes the difference. For today's regular season contest between the Anderson University Trojans and your North Greenville Crusaders. For today's starting lineups, first for the visiting Trojans. At shortstop, number 10, Carly Hurtado. At center field, number 9, Molly Child. At catcher, number 2, Kayla Niles. Batting at designated hitter, number 27, Augie Pena. At third base, number 6, Michaela Smith. At left field, number 4, Madison Bivin. At right field, number 24, Courtney Setnon. At first base, number 20, Rachel Bearfield. At second base, number 13, Casey Grant. And at pitcher, number 30, Randy Bettis. Trojans are coached by Tommy Hewitt and assisted by Mike Thrasher, Matt Thrasher, and Danielle Swagger. And now the starting lineup for your North Greenville Crusaders. At shortstop, number 1, Shayna Finley. At right field, number 15, Jordan Farmer. Batting at designated hitter, number 17, Kate Lee. At third base, number 25, Megan Johnson. At center field, number 5, Grace DeBoer. At first base, number 13, Morgan Herlon. At second base, number 6, Kelsey River. At catcher, number 16, Morgan Rowe. At left field, number 14, Greer Kilman. Pitching for the Crusaders, number 21, Carson O'Donnell. Your Crusaders are coached by Sarah Hall. She is assisted by Shelly Robinson and Tori Freeman. At this time, we ask that you please rise for the invocation and remain standing as we honor America with the playing of our national anthem. Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father God, thank you for this day that you've given us. Thank you for the many blessings that you provide for us each and every day. Keep both players safe on and off the field, and ultimately let them play for your glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
K-pop?
And with that, we welcome you once again. A little bit of a surprise to start this season at the old Pepsi softball field, but that is where we're at for a couple of more weeks before we move on to the new field, which I will show you in just a moment what the progress is there. But here we are, the middle of the day here on a Thursday in Tigerville. North Greenville coming in with a 4-0 record. A two-game sweep at Benedict on February 2nd. And then a sweep here in Tigerville against St. Augustine's College. Anderson 3-3. So bring up their schedule. They split a two-game series against Lees McRae and then swept Southern Wesleyan on February 4th and then lost both games to Georgia College February 6th. So that's where we are today.
Now batting for Anderson, number 10, the shortstop, Carly Hurtado.
So here's Carly Hurtado. Pitching for the Crusaders is number, well, it said, actually, that's been a change. Maybe not, apparently. That is Carson O'Donnell, but the live stats had a different number for her. Ball put in play, but just foul. So I'll put the count at 0-2. And that is indeed Carson O'Donnell. She comes in with a 3 ERA, does have a win this season. That one just outside. Even the count at 2-2. That one way outside. So a good at bat by Carly Hurtado. Even if she gets out, at least she made O'Donnell throw a lot of pitches. And caught, foul tip, strike three, and that'll be out number one. So here is Molly Child for the Trojans. She comes in with a 294 average. So that first pitch is a little outside for ball one, maybe a little bit low as well. Ends up just a little inside, nice looking breaking ball, but couldn't quite find the plate. This broadcast is a little unusual, working alone out here in right center field today, but we'll be joined by our normal play-by-play commentator later for the second game, hopefully. But O'Donnell's struggling a little bit. 3-0 is the count. And that one just finds the inside corner. Wind will be a factor today. It's from where the camera is currently, it's pretty much blowing from behind the camera to in front of it. And that was an unassisted out. So with two outs, that brings up Kayla Niles. That one finds the outside corner for strike one. You heard the outfielders just a moment ago say to back up, so Niles is a good hitter. 375 average coming in, including a home run and six RBIs. But O'Donnell doing a great job of finding that outside corner of the plate. Pretty hard to hit home runs at that location. So 0-2. Almost went around, but was able to hold up. Ground ball to short, over to first in time for out number three. And that will do it for the top of the first. So Anderson gets nothing. They did get one runner. No, excuse me, they ended up going three up, three down, so never mind. So we head to the bottom of the first in just a moment here on the North Greenville Sports Network.
For the Crusaders at shortstop, number one, Shayna Finley.
So here we go for the bottom of the first. Shayna Finley first up for the Crusaders. First pitch, maybe a little low, possibly a little inside as well. Pitcher for Anderson is Randy Bettis. That one finds the upper part of the zone. Bettis does have a win, in fact, a 0.55 ERA and 12 and two-thirds innings pitched. Has only given up one earned run, so a nice start to the season for her. That second pitch is a ball. Shayna Finley comes in with a 300 average. And a fly ball in foul territory. It will fall. So that'll even up the count at 2-2. Right fielder Courtney Zintnar tried to get over to it, but could not quite get there. Way outside. So, just like the top of the first at bat in the bottom of the first begins with a full count. And that one in foul territory, that one is out of play. That one put in play over to first in time for out number one.
Now batting for the Crusaders.
That put out by the second baseman, number 13, Casey Grant. And Shayna Finley is retired. First pitch to Jordan Farmer is a strike. Farmer playing right field. That one fouled back, so that'll be a quick 0-2 count. Farmer picking up right where she left off last season, a 429 average coming into today, 3 hits and 9 at bats, including a double, does not have a home run as of yet, but she's definitely capable of it. Possibly a waste pitch there. Make the count 1-2. And swing and a miss. So Farmer goes down swinging. That'll be a quick two outs.
Out batting, the designated hitter, number 17, Kate Lee.
So here comes Kate Lee, a nice start to the season. 5 hits and 10 at-bats. That's a .500 average, including a home run. That one just finds the outside corner. And swing and a miss. Possibly a foul tip there, but it is a strike nonetheless. Swing and quick little pop up to the shortstop, Carly Hurtado, for an easy out number 3. So that will do it. Nothing going on for the Crusaders either. Both teams go 3 up, 3 down in the first. So we'll head to the second in just a moment here on the North Greenville Sports Network.
Batting for Anderson, the designated hitter, number 27, Augie Pena.
So here we go for the top of the second. Augie Pena will lead off for AU. Might notice the black color beside Anderson's logo and then the white beside NGU. Both teams wearing black jerseys. We usually use those colors to signify which team is the color jersey, but with both of them black, we're doing pants instead. So North Greenville in the white pants, Anderson in the black pants. First pitch to Augie Pena is a strike, and that one misses outside. That one misses, so a 2-1 count. That one found the plate, so 0-2. 9 balls, 10 strikes so far for Carson O'Donnell. So a full count. That one outside, so a leadoff walk.
Now batting for Anderson, number 6, Michaela.
So Pena starts things off with a walk. And that'll bring up Michaela Smith playing third base. That misses outside. Line drive into the outfield for a base hit. So Anderson may be in business here.
How batting for Anderson? At left field, number four, Madison Bivens.
So with men on, women on first and second. That'll bring up the left fielder Bivens. First pitch is high. It's Madison Bivens, a 154 average coming into today. And that one high and outside. O'Donnell's struggling a little bit. That one low and outside. O'Donnell in danger of walking. The base is loaded. And that one does find the zone. Still has a hole to climb out of, but a nice way to start. Just finds the zone. Trojans did not agree. So another full count. And a pop up. It's gonna go behind the Anderson dugout. So it'll still be a full count. That one out of play as well. So 30 pitches for Carson O'Donnell. Still trying to fight in this count. Madison Bivens looking for a hit or a walk, and she's got it. So the base is now loaded for the Trojans with nobody out. That'll bring up Courtney Zentnar. She has struggled to begin the season. One hit and 15 at-bats for a 0.67 batting average. But for that, we'll have a visit to the mound. In between innings, we will show you some drone footage of the new softball field. Unfortunately, the weather over the last few months has caused a delay in that field being ready, but boy, once it is ready, it is going to be a first-class facility. As here we go. First pitch is a ball to Zentnar. Swing and a pop up to the pitcher. So a nice way to start, forces a soft pop up right back to her for out number one. So here comes Rachel Bearfield, a 133 average, two hits and 15 at bats. First pitch to her was a ball. swing and a ground ball in foul territory, so it'll be out of play. Swing and a miss. I think she regrets swinging at that one. I think she was looking to rip it. But instead, it was too far inside, so she came up empty. That one way outside. Possibly a waste pitch there. Swing, and that one down the third baseline, but foul. So the count will still be 2-2. Line drive right to the pitcher, and they get the double play. So North Greenville with a big break there, but they will take it. So Anderson had the bases loaded with nobody out, and they get nothing. It went right back to Carson O'Donnell, and you can't really blame Pena, who was at third, for not being able to get back in time. You're taught to leave the bag and take a couple of steps on contact, but it was a line drive right back to O'Donnell, and she just simply had to throw it back to third for that third out. So North Greenville with a big break. And Anderson ends up scoreless. And we'll go ahead and show you some of the drone footage of the new softball complex. As you can see, it's all turf. And two of the biggest dugouts you're ever going to see in college softball. So they will have that luxury for them, as well as the visiting team, too. Both teams will have bullpens beside each dugout, and also a batting cages along the first base side. So definitely a first-class facility, and just about complete with phase one of a three-phase project. I know that there's eventual plans for a permanent press box, as well as permanent seating. So they certainly have that to look forward to. So we're heading to the bottom of the second in just a moment. Leading off will be the third baseman, number 25, Megan Johnson, followed by Grace DeBoer and then Morgan Herlong.
Now batting for your Crusaders at third base, number 25, Megan Johnson.
Megan Johnson comes in with a .200 batting average, 2 hits and 10 at-bats. She does have a home run. First pitch right in there for a called strike. Swing and a miss. Quick strike two. Ball got away from her a little bit, ended up way outside for ball one. Swing and a ground ball right to first, but just foul. And a pop up, actually a fly ball to center, to shallow center field, actually caught by, it was a Child who made the catch for out number one. Thank you. And we're actually getting this. There has been a pitching change. Augie Pena, now the pitcher. Swing and a miss. Called strike, makes it 1-2. Augie Pena was actually the starting pitcher. There was a mistake. Looks like there was a mistake in the lineup to begin the game. It had Bettis as the starting pitcher, but she is actually the designated player. So the count for Pena now 2-2. Apologize for getting that lineup wrong. Grace DeBoer, the batter. Swing and a miss. Four strike three, so that'll be two quick outs for Anderson. And North Greenville has yet to have a runner on base.
Now batting for your Crusaders at first base, number 13, Morgan Herlong.
So here's Morgan Herlong. Great start to the season. Four hits and seven at-bats, a .571 average. Takes a big rip at that one, but misses. And that one fouled back. So an 0-2 count. A foul tip. No, she apparently missed it. But will be out off of the throw to first base. So nothing going on for the Crusaders. Again, three up, three down. So we head to the bottom of the second in just a moment here on the North Greenville Sports Network. So here is Casey Grant for the Trojans to start off the third. First pitch is a ball. Carson O'Donnell is still the pitcher. That one way outside. Misses. So another leadoff walk. And it goes back to the top of the lineup, Carly Hurtado. She's 0-for-1 with a strikeout. But does have one of the highest averages on the team. Highest among starters, a .500 average coming in. 7-14 coming into today, but tries the drag bunt, but it's going to be fouled. That one is a called strike, finds the top of the zone. So an 0-2 count. That one high and outside, possible waste pitch there. And that one was fouled off of, looked like her leg, so count will remain 1-2. So the way the lineups are looking, Anderson has a true designated hitter. Excuse me, North Greenville has a true designated hitter. And that one is going to fall for a hit. So Anderson with their second hit of the game. And they're in business again. Runners on first and second with nobody out. So North Greenville has the true designated hitter in Kate Lee. Anderson does not have a designated hitter in their lineup. Their pitcher, Pena, is batting cleanup. Head coach for Anderson, Tommy Hewitt, having a quick word with Child. Child is 0-for-1, grounded out her first time up. Anderson looked like they wanted to go, but did not. And gets the bunt down over to first. It is in time, so a successful sacrifice bunt for Child. Moves the runners over to second and third with just one out. So here comes Niles. Kayla Niles comes in with a 375 average. And she grounded out her first time as well. First pitch low and outside for ball one. Swinging a ground ball to third, over to first, in time, runners can't advance. It was Megan Johnson with that put out. So here comes the pitcher, Augie Pena. And that one is a called strike. Somehow found the outside corner. And Pena did walk her first time up. And that one just inside. That one in the dirt. Brings up a 2-1 count. No runs, two hits, no errors for Anderson. And that finds the outside corner. For North Greenville, nothing across the board. No runs, no hits, no errors. And that one way high and outside. First base is open, so she doesn't have to fire it right in there. Ground ball finds the gap, and that's going to score a run. So Anderson strikes first. And they will have runners on first and third with two outs. So here comes Michaela Smith. She did get a hit her first time at bat. Called strike. 60th pitch for O'Donnell coming up. Outside to make the count 1-1. And that one was, I believe it was fouled back.
I got you on your head.
Count is 1-2. O'Donnell trying to limit the damage here in the top of the third. Has given up one run, but one strikeout from ending the top of the inning, and that's what she does, a strikeout. So a run for Anderson will put them ahead, and we'll head to the bottom of the third when we come back here on the North Greenville Sports Network. So as we return, leading off for the Crusaders will be Kelsey Rivers, followed by Morgan Roach, then the number 9 hitter in the lineup, Greer Kilman. North Greenville has yet to have a base runner. So that is the bottom three of the order. Pena has had a nice two innings to start. As we mentioned, no runners on base, so obviously no hits and no runs, no walks either. Does have two strikeouts. So here's a second baseman, Kelsey Rivers. Went for a bunt, but it's outside. Rivers with a .500 average coming in, but just 4 at-bats, so she has 2 hits, including a double. That finds the zone. Swing and a miss right down the middle, but came up empty. Goes for a foul ball, but it's going to drop, so it'll remain 1-2. Swing and a miss for out number 1. So Rivers goes down swinging. That'll bring up the catcher, Morgan Roach.
Sorry, catcher, number 16, Morgan Roach.
Swings at the first pitch, but it's fouled back for strike one. That one a little low. That one low as well. Swing and got a hold of that one, but it's ripped down the third base line, foul, out of play. So an even count with one out here in the bottom of the third. That one a little bit low, so a full count now. Swing and one rip down the line, but that one is foul as well. That was Pena's 40th pitch. Swing and a drive, and that one is gone. So just like that, North Greenville ties up the game 1-1. That's North Greenville's first hit of the game, first base runner, first everything, but proves to be effective. So here's Greer Kilman, two hits and three at-bats, so a .667 batting average. That was actually Morgan Roach's first hit of the season. It only had four at-bats prior coming in. Swing and a miss by Greer Kilman, makes it 2-1. And this one is swung and it's gonna be caught in right field for out number two. Courtney Zintnar with that put out in right field. That one fouled back. That one way high. Try to get a breaking ball there, but must have held on to it a little too long. And tried the fastball, but ended up in the same location. That one right in there. So the count now even at 2-2, nobody on base. North Greenville has scored a run thanks to a home run by Morgan Roach. That one fouled and will be out of play. and was able to somehow make contact with that one. Ends up behind the press box, so it'll remain 2-2. And that one's going to be caught just behind the second base position. That was Grant that made the out for out number three. So a run and a hit will even up the game as the third inning comes to an end. We'll head to the fourth in just a moment here on the North Greenville Sports Network. So the top of the fourth begins. Madison Bivens to lead off for the Trojans. Sharp line drive to center field. Didn't have time to change the camera, but it will be an out. That one went right to the center fielder, Grace DeBoer. So one pitch and one out. Good way to start the top of the fourth for Carson O'Donnell. So Courtney Zintnar with her second at bat of the day. First pitch way high for ball one. And that one is ripped and forget about it. Home run, and just like that, Anderson right back in the lead. This field isn't particularly deep. Left field is at about 195 feet, and right field is right at about 200, so not much of a difference there. And that is something that will be different with the new field. Not sure how much deeper, but you can just tell by looking at the outfield, it is quite a bit deeper than Pepsi Field here. That one lifted into foul territory off a car. Count now 0-2. That one fouled away. That one's high to make it 1-2. That one fouled into the North Greenville dugout. Everybody appears to be okay. If you're following along with the live stats, the score is 2-1. That ball definitely cleared the fence. I think there was a scoring mistake, so I'm sure that'll be fixed. It was Courtney Zentnar with the home run. That one high and outside, so a full count. And that's outside, so Rachel Bearfield gets on base.
Now batting for Anderson, playing second base, number 13, Casey Grant.
So here's the nine hitter for the Anderson lineup. It's Casey Grant. She walked her first appearance, did later score. That pitch in there for a strike. Do have Randy Bettis warming up for Anderson in their bullpen. And that one gets away, did not make contact with the bat apparently, so Bearfield advances to second. And apparently that was called a strike. And it was, so umpire indicating 0-2, so she did go for it. Wasn't sure if she pulled the bunt back or not, and she definitely went around that time. So that'll be a strikeout. So Grant goes down swinging, so it goes back to the top of the order, Hurtado. And that hit her. So runners on first and second now for Anderson. So here's Molly Child. That one in foul territory, it does go out of play. Child 0 for 1. She had a sacrifice bunt as well, so two plate appearances, but just one official at bat. That's low and outside. 80th pitch for O'Donnell coming up. Low and inside, 2-1. Low and outside. So a 3-1 count to Child. And that is inside, so the bases are going to be loaded. Looks like there's going to be a visit to the mound. Looks like North Greenville does have a player warming up in the bullpen. Not seeing the number as of yet. Yeah. It doesn't look like they're going to be, doesn't look like a change will be made here, but the bases are loaded with just two outs. And North Greenville's pretty fortunate that Anderson does not have more runs than they do. They left the bases loaded in the first. Say they have at least five runners left on base so far today. And that finds the zone. And does make contact with it, but it's going to be a force out at first. So Anderson leaves the bases loaded. North Greenville continues to be very fortunate so far in this game. Let's see how many. And it wasn't actually, it actually was not the first inning. Anderson went three up, three down. But in the second, they did have the bases loaded with nobody out and then had the double play to end the inning. So they had two left on base in that inning, two more left on base in the third, and now three left on base in the top of the fourth. So seven runners left on base in just four innings for the Trojans. That's not what they want to keep going with. North Greenville has had nobody left on base, so they've made the most out of their base runners, but just haven't had a lot of them as of yet. For the Crusaders, it'll start at the number two spot in the lineup, Jordan Farmer, followed by Kate Lee, then Megan Johnson. So the 2-3-4 hitters coming up, the heart of the lineup for the Crusaders. So a change will not be made for the Trojans as Bettis is still beyond right field warming up. So they'll stick with Pena. So Jordan Farmer leads off for the Crusaders in the bottom of the fourth. She struck out her first at bat. Swings at the first pitch, and that one's lifted high and just behind home plate, and that'll be an easy out, number one. Kayla Niles with that put out in the catcher position. And that one swung on but fouled away. Swung on and missed. North Greenville being aggressive in the bottom of the fourth, but hasn't been able to do anything with it as of yet. Three pitches pitched, and North Greenville swung at all of them and make that four. So a strikeout. Looks like Pena may be starting to settle in. That one finds the zone. First pitch this inning that North Greenville hasn't swung at. And that one fouled away. And does make contact with it, but it's going to be right back to Pena, fires it to first in time for out number three, just a seven-pitch inning for Pena, and she is definitely settling in. Augie Pena, she is a junior from Geneva, Alabama. So that does it for the fourth inning. We'll head to the fifth in just a moment. Low-scoring game here in Tigerville to open up game number one, and you are watching the North Greenville Sports Network. So speaking of Augie Pena, here she comes to bat. Augie Pena 1-for-1 with an RBI. Outside corner for strike one. Off of the catcher. They're saying it was a foul ball. Pena thought she was hit by the pitch, but it was called a foul ball, so it's going to be 0-2 actually. And rips that one, but in foul territory. And that one fouled as well. A little bit low, maybe a little bit outside as well, so that brings the count to 1-2. That one way outside. That one fouled.
Are you here, Carson?
91 pitches for O'Donnell. And makes contact with that one, and it's going to go into the bleachers. So another foul ball. And swung on and missed. So Pena put up a good fight, but ends up striking out for out number one here in the top of the fifth. So Michaela Smith will come up to the plate. She is 1-for-2 with the strikeout. First pitch, she watches, but hits the inside corner for strike one. That one high for ball, make it 1-1. Ground ball to short, over to first, in time. Shayna Finley with that put out at short. And with two outs, Madison Bivens will step back up to the plate. Swung on, and it's a deep fly ball that's going to be. And it's actually, no, it couldn't be caught, and that's a home run. Didn't realize it until it had already happened, but Anderson with their third run in three consecutive innings. Left fielder Greer Kilman continued to back up, and the wall just barely prevented her from making that catch. I think she had a little bit more room than she ended up having. So Madison Bivens with a home run. So Courtney Zentner steps up to the plate, 2-0 count. And that one misses as well, and that was O'Donnell's 100th pitch. Zentner is 1-for-2 with an RBI, and she homered her last at bat. That one does find the zone. And that misses. And there are two outs. So here is Rachel Bearfield, number 8 hitter in the Anderson lineup, 0-for-1 with a walk. And it's a stolen base attempt, and she is caught stealing. Gunned down by Morgan Roach. Two retired the side, but not before Anderson strikes again. So we head to the bottom of the fifth momentarily here on the North Greenville Sports Network. Augie Pena, 5'9", fires a ball to Greer Kilman. Excuse me, that's Grace DeBoer. High in the zone to even the count at 2-2. Bettis no longer warming up in the Anderson bullpen, so I think they're going to stick with Pena until she starts to wear out. But as good as she looked in the last inning, that might be a while. Going way high. Swing and a miss. Strike three.
Now batting for your Crusaders. Playing first base, number 13, Morgan Herlon.
So here's Morgan Herlon, 0-1. She grounded out. Makes contact with that one, but it's going to be fouled away. Right in there. Another quick 0-2 count for Pena. And hits the edge of the bat and ends up getting into center field for a base hit. It's North Greenville's second hit of the game right off the tip of the bat. About as slow of a grounder as you'll see, but it's just hitting the right place. And we might be having a change in the North Greenville lineup. It looks like we will be. So it will be a pinch runner for Kelsey Rivers. No, excuse me, Herlong. It'll be Michelle Brown who comes in for her. First pitch is a ball. Called strike. And squares the bunt. She gets it down. Tried to bunt it at the last second, but it is a successful sacrifice bunt to move Michelle Brown up to second.
Now batting for your Crusaders. Catching number 16, Morgan Rowe.
Morgan Roach, 1-for-1 with a homer.
Hit it!
And it looks like we might have a change here, or just a conference. Looks like that will be the case. Critical time in this game. North Greenville with the tying run at the plate. She homered earlier, so certainly understandable why Anderson head coach Tommy Hewitt would want to have a word there and make sure that they don't give her a pitch to tee off on.
Here we go, Augie.
So they'll try to attack her on the outside, but that one a little bit too outside for a 1-0 count. That one outside as well. And that one finds the zone. 75 pitches for Augie Pena. She's looked pretty solid today, but so that one just finds the outside corner. So an even count at 2-2. Big pitch coming up here. That one way high and outside. So here we go, full count. Michelle Brown at second. Don't expect her to run here. And that one lifted in foul territory. It will fall and be out of play. And makes contact with it and over to first in time for out number three. So North Greenville strands one and comes up empty in the bottom of the fifth. So on to the top of the sixth in just a moment. So we do have a new pitcher, 23 Anna Rogers, a sophomore out of, not sure if I'm pronouncing this correctly or not, Lotta, South Carolina. And she did pitch quite a bit last season. So it's the bottom of the order for the Trojans. We'll start with Bearfield. She's 0-for-1 with a walk. Breaking ball right in there for a strike. Anderson scored a run in the third, a run in the fourth, and a run in the fifth. We'll see if they can continue that streak. That one outside. Just a little bit high. North Greenville wanted a strike there, but didn't quite get it, and it's 3-1. Swung on and lifted to shallow left field, caught by Shayna Finley for out number one. Casey Grant steps up to the plate. She is the bottom hitter in the Anderson lineup. She's 0 for 1 with a walk, and she did later score. That one low, so a 3-0 count. On deck is Hurtado, who did get a hit earlier in the game and was hit by the pitch as well. And that's outside, so a 4-pitch walk. Gets away a little bit, runner will advance. I think that's got to go down as a wild pitch there. Definitely got in the dirt before it got to the catcher, Morgan Roach. Just gets in the zone for a called strike. Not where Roach wanted it, but did end up in the strike zone. And that one low. There was another change. Morgan Herlong is now at first base for Michelle Brown. You are allowed to re-enter the game once, as here is a base hit, and the run will score. So an RBI single for Hurtado, her second hit of the game, and Anderson does continue that streak of having one run in four straight innings. Here goes the runner, and she is safe. Anderson starting to challenge Morgan Roach. I believe that was a ball. Scoreboard does not say anything currently, and now it says a ball, so 1-0. Right in there for a strike.
You got it! Come on, North Greenville!
makes contact with that one as high as it was in the zone, but fouled away. So a 1-2 count now. Anderson with 4 runs off of 6 hits, no errors. North Greenville, 1 run, 2 hits, and no errors for them either. And that's in there. Called strike 3 for out number 2. So Child goes down looking. Kayla Niles, 0 for 3. 3 ground outs. Called strike to Niles. Hasn't gotten off to a great start today, but 6 hits and 16 at-bats coming in for a 375 average, including a home run and 6 RBIs, so she's certainly a threat anytime she comes up to the plate. That one high and inside. That one way high and inside. Went after that one, but all she could do was foul that one away. So an even count with 2 outs. And went after a ball in the dirt. The throw to first is in time, so not a good looking at bat for Niles, and now she is 0 for 4. But Anderson scores another one. 1 run in 4 consecutive innings for the Trojans, and so North Greenville is going to have to string some hits together. If they're going to come back in this one, they'll have 6 outs left to do so. And we'll return in just a moment here on the North Greenville Sports Network. So here we go for the bottom of the 6th. First pitch is a called strike. And it is a new pitcher. Bettis was warming up a few innings ago, and she finally comes in for Pena, so her day's done. That one high. One We'll go over Pena's numbers in just a moment. That one way high as well. Swinging a ground ball into right center field for a base hit. Nice way to start for the Crusaders, just their third hit of the game. So for Pena, five innings pitched, two hits, one run it was earned, no walks, five strikeouts. So pretty solid numbers overall for her. Yeah, deep fly ball that's going to be caught. Didn't quite have enough on it. Wind might have played a little bit of a factor. It's wind has actually calmed down a good bit since the beginning of this game.
And that'll bring to the plate number 15, Jordan Farmer.
Gray Sutherland joining us. Finally.
Yeah.
He had class.
Yeah, sorry about that one.
It's all good.
Anyway, here we are in the bottom of the sixth inning. North Greenville down three runs to Anderson, 4-1. Pitch on its way, way outside for a ball. That's ball one. Randy Bettis on the mound for Anderson. Right-handed sophomore out of Hull, Georgia. Pitch on its way to Farmer. Swing on. Swung on. Drifts high to left field. And this one's going to be caught by the left fielder for Anderson for the second out. Madison Business on the play. So two down for North Greenville. And the DH up on the up to bat. Number 17, Kate Lee. Pitch on its way, outside for a ball. We've got Kilman over at first, taking a big step, but cannot move up. Here's the 1-0. Pulls back a bunt, Kilman goes to second, and she is gonna be safe, sliding in. Now Kilman at second, runner in scoring position for North Greenville.
They haven't had a lot of those today.
Here's the 2-0. This one, grounder to third. Kilman has to hold up, and they will get the force out at first to end the inning. So we're through six with Anderson holding a 4-1 lead over North Greenville. We'll head to the top of the seventh, final inning of play here in regulation. So we'll see what Anderson can do, see if they can tack on any insurance here on the North Greenville Sports Network. So up first for Anderson here in the top of the seventh, under number 27, Algie Pena. And on the mound for North Greenville, number 23, Anna Rogers. First pitch, swing and a miss for strike one to Pena.
Pena 1-for-2 with an RBI. Also struck out and walked.
And takes ball one way upstairs. They're leaving the count up at 1-1. Now here comes the 1-1. This one drifts into left field, and it's going to be caught for the first out. Great play over there by the left fielder for North Greenville, number 14, Greer Kilman. Now Michaela Smith steps up to the plate for Anderson with one down, a freshman from Lawrence, South Carolina.
She's 1-for-3 with a strikeout.
Pitch on its way from Rogers. Called strike inside corner. Now here comes the 0-1. This one misses the zone, just inside for a ball, 1-1. Now here comes the 1-1. This one drifts high for ball two. Now the 2-1. This one skips off the plate in front of the catcher for North Greenville. That will be ball three. Now the 3-1. Called ball four up high. And that will send the leadoff runner to first base for Anderson. And now up to the plate, number four, Madison Bivens.
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 There you go. 1-for-2 with an RBI, and she did. That hit was a home run.
Takes a rip at the first one, trying to do the same thing, but missed it, strike one.
There's been three home runs hit in this game, two by Anderson, one by North Greenville.
Now the 0-1. Called strike right down the middle. Fooled, it's 0-2.
Fooled her with the breaking ball there. She was ready for the fastball, but when it wasn't there, she...
I think she got the fastball on the first pitch. I don't think Rogers would go for back-to-back. Now the 0-2. Takes this waist pitch up high, ball one. Now here comes the next one. And this one just barely missed up high. That'll even the count up at 2-2. With one down here in the top of the seventh, swing and a miss on that one. And Bivens will go down swinging for the second out. Now number 24, Courtney Zentnar, up to bat.
Might have heard the outfielders talking to each other. She is 1-for-2, and that hit was a home run as well.
Takes a called strike on the inside edge. Here's the 0-1. Swing and a miss for strike two.
Yeah, Rogers doing a good job of mixing in fastballs with breaking balls, and it's really keeping Anderson guessing.
Now Rogers ahead in the count, 0-2, two down, trying to get out of the top of the seventh. Up high, ball one. Tried to get her to chase that. She didn't go for it. The 1-2, up high. Leaving the count up at 2-2. Seems after Rogers gets ahead in the count, she starts working that top part of the zone, see if she can get the hitter to chase it. So far, no luck yet. Got her to go after that one. That one, breaking ball, sank low, and caught Zitnar swinging. So that will be the end of the top of the seventh. North Greenville hold serve, but they're down three. We'll head to the bottom of the seventh. Last chance for North Greenville here in game one of this doubleheader versus Anderson. We'll see what happens in the bottom of the seventh here on the North Greenville Sports Network. Bottom of the seventh, final chance for North Greenville versus Anderson. They need to make up three to tie, four to win outright. First up to the plate for North Greenville is Megan Johnson.
She's 0 for 2, a ground out and a fly out.
Takes ball one low and away. Bettis still on the mound for Anderson, trying to close it out.
She would be credited with the save if she can close it out here. And then Pena is in line for the win.
Hits this one to short, throw her to first. Will get Johnson easily, one down for Anderson. Now number five, Grace DeBoer.
And she is 0 for 2 with two strikeouts.
Held off the first one for a ball. Now the 1-0. Called strike outside edge from Bettis. It'll be 1-1. The 1-1, low and away, ball two. Next pitch, outside, ball three. So DeBoer inches ahead in the count. This might force Bettis to try and force something inside. The 3-1, down low in the dirt, ball four to DeBoer. She will walk down the first. Go
So Morgan Herlong steps up to the plate. She is one for two.
Takes strike one right down the middle.
Wind has picked back up. Might hear it in the microphone, but blowing from behind us towards home plate. So any long fly ball, especially in this area, is just going to die.
And takes this one low and away. Ball one. It'll be 1-1 count to Herlong. And now the 1-1. Swung on this one to left field, going back to the fence and over the wall for a bottom of the seventh home run for North Greenville. Well, that one was low enough to get underneath the wind and have enough speed to carry out of the park.
Yeah, it's a good thing it was a pretty hard hit ball. If that one floated around a little bit, it probably wouldn't have made it over, but that one cleared it by, I'd say, a good 10 feet or so, something like that. So that's two runs. North Greenville still needs one more to tie it, but great way to start.
So at the base is empty. And the score now 4-3. Ball one outside. And Allen, who's up to bat?
That would be Kelsey Rivers.
She pops this one up to the shallow left and is caught for the second out of the inning. So the shortstop, Carly Hurtado for Anderson, doing the work here in the bottom of the seventh.
So now the hero for North Greenville will have to be Morgan Roach, who did homer earlier in this game. So there's certainly an opportunity for her to tie it up or at least get on base. That was her first hit of the season.
First pitch to her, low and away, ball one.
Bet is still in line for the save as long as she doesn't give up another run.
Now the 1-0 outside, ball two.
As good of a game as Pena pitched, you'd hate for a win to get away from her, but that's what North Greenville's trying to do.
This one swung on, driven to left field. It's going to hang up there. And that will end the ball game as the left fielder for Anderson, number four, Bivens, will end the ball game. And North Greenville takes its first loss of the regular season to Anderson by a score of 4-3. Well, it looked good there for a minute as North Greenville was able to tack on two runs late. Just the momentum train ran out of steam a little early, and that will end the first game between North Greenville and Anderson.
So it looks like Carson O'Donnell will have the loss for that game. She pitched five innings, gave up five hits, three earned runs, six walks, four strikeouts. And then Anna Rogers came in and relieved her and pitched pretty well. Two innings pitched, one hit, one earned run, two walks, four strikeouts. And we mentioned earlier that Pena will pick up the win. Five innings pitched, two hits, one earned run, no walks, five strikeouts. And Bettis with the save, who came in and pitched two innings, two hits, two earned runs, and one walk.
So that will be the end of the first game. North Greenville taking their first loss. We'll look to rebound in the second game. A doubleheader being played today will start very shortly here on the North Greenville Sports Network, and we'll see who will be starting on the mound for North Greenville and Anderson here in just a few moments. So stick with us. Don't go anywhere. We'll be broadcasting live the second game here in just a moment.
And we will go offline just temporarily for probably about 5 minutes or so just to get everything reset, and we'll pick the stream back up as soon as possible. So you don't have to do anything with the Ustream page. It should go back to live automatically once we do once we do start broadcasting again. So we hope you stick with us, and we appreciate you watching.